Welcome to Washington Hospital Today, dedicated to informing residents about healthcare topics and issues. Through programs featuring community forums and free health and wellness classes, our goal is to empower community members with the information needed to make informed health decisions. Washington Hospital has been providing healthcare to the residents of the Washington Township Healthcare District for the past 60 years. Today's presenter is Sherri Plaza. Sherri Plaza is a certified yoga instructor and group fitness instructor.
Okay, who relates to this? I did a push-up today. Well, actually, I fell down, but I had to use my arms to get back up, so close enough, and now I need chocolate. Is that your version of exercising? Yeah, okay. Let's see if we can maybe give you some tips today to help you get closer to, today I will love myself enough to exercise, because that's what it's for. Okay, so, but before we start talking about it, we're gonna get up. If you have enough balance and strength to stand on up. Not required, but we've been sitting for over an hour, so probably you'll feel good, okay? Okay, so take the feet a little bit apart. Feel a good stance there, and let's roll our shoulders. And then breathe in, take your arms up. As you exhale, circle them down. Let's go the other way. Inhale, lift up. Exhale, take them down. And again, breathe in and lift. And release it down. Take the right arm forward, bring it across your body, and then pull the elbow back. Reach across. Don't worry if you're doing the opposite arm. Doesn't matter. We'll get both sides. Pull it back. So we're turning a little bit, getting some motion into our spine, getting some movement into the shoulder, and then take that arm down. Okay, other side. Forward, across, pull it back, and reach and turn the other way, and pull it back, and reach, and pull it back. Okay, hands to your hips. Lean over to the right, and back up. If you're like, I'm a little teapot, remember you were like preschool age, or if you have kids, remember teaching that to them? Side to side. Okay, bend the knees a little bit. Shift the hips side to side, shake it out. Make some circles around. Oop, go the other way. Reverse. Okay, take the right heel forward. Lift up the toes, and then tap it up and down, up and down. You may feel in the calf, a little stretch. And let's go to the other side, left foot, up and down. Up and down. Okay, lift up the knees. A few marches in place. If you want to, you're near the table. If you want to hold on, that works too. Swing the arms a little bit. Okay, hold it still. Okay, I'm going to teach you a little routine that we do in our Keep It Moving class. Lucy mentioned that's one of the classes I teach here at the Wellness Center just down the other side of this building. That class is mainly geared, most of the people there are like older adults. I'm the teacher, I'm the youngest, I'll give you a sense, okay? And some people are only sitting in a chair and doing the movements. Some people stand for part of it or sit down. It's really gentle. It's a good way to ease into some, adding some exercise into your life. And we have a lot of fun. I swear sometimes I can't even start the class because everybody's chatting too much. Okay, so there's a few simple moves I'm going to teach you, and then we're going to put it to music, okay? So we're going to take, alternate the foot forward. I don't know if you all can see me. I'll move around. The right foot's going to come forward. Right foot alternate, right foot. If you want, you add in some arms. Heels forward, okay? Then we're gonna take it to the side. Out to the side, tap to the other side. We can do some arms if you want, right? Okay. Then we're gonna move, our chorus is gonna be, we're going to march, 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 march three times. Arms are gonna go out, out, out. We're gonna cross our hands. We're gonna hit the legs. Cross. And hit the legs. Lean to the side, other side, side, and side. Good enough, okay? Let me get my music going. It's to a song you may have heard on the radio.
Sherri Plaza's iPhone.
Okay, we're gonna start with that foot forward. So we're gonna go right, left, right, left. So you're gonna have fun, huh? Whoa. Okay, so the last time we're gonna take the foot to the side, go to the right. Tap and tap, alternate, alternate. Okay, here's our chorus. We're gonna march three times. Arms to the side. Again to the side. One, two, three. One, two, three. Open out. Oh, don't worry, yeah? Okay, we're gonna cross and slap. So X, slap. Cross and slap. You guys are good. Okay, lean to the right, to the left. One time more each side. Cross and slap. Cross, cross and slap. Okay, back to the heels, go forward. So forward. This side's all in a row, huh? Okay, tap to the right, tap to the right, left. Okay, we're gonna go back to our march. One, two, three. Listen to the words. One, two, three. One. Arms out. Out. One, two, three. Arms out. One more time. X. And slap. X and slap. Okay, lean side to side. Here we go, X, slap, X and slap. Okay, lean right, left. Okay, alternate the feet forward. Here we go, right and left. Okay, march, one, two, three. Arms out. Bring it in. This time, lift it up. Ooh, shake it up. One, two, three. Arms out. And out again. Reach it up. X, X, and slap. You'll never listen to the song on the radio again.
Not in the same way.
No way, lean right. I drive and this comes on. I'm like, ooh. Cross and slap. Okay, lean to the right, and left, and right. Right foot forward. We're gonna get ready for one big final clap. Woo! Okay, see? All right, okay, have a seat. That was fun, you did excellent. Its song is, what's her name? L. King. L. King? I haven't heard her do anything else. All right, so now we got to start thinking a little bit. So I'm going to write over here. I'm going to audience participation again. So tell me what you know of, or what you think are some of the benefits of being active.
Feeling happy.
Feeling happy, okay. You feel good, okay. It'll work. What's another benefit?
Less tired.
Sometimes it seems like it should be counterintuitive, right? Yeah. What?
Improved metabolism.
Metabolism? And you said health?
Muscle.
Okay. Metabolism. Blood pumping.
More flexible.
More flexible. And why do you think it's important to be more flexible? You won't fall down. I'm going to say add to that being agile, right? Good for balance. Good for balance. Less stiff. Yep, okay. Joints, yeah. Joints, okay. Energy. I'm going to up here, less tired, energy. So yeah, so we know health, right? So better sleep. I don't want to flip over, better sleep. Happy, good mood, right? So the good endorphins kick in and you feel happier, less stress, right? To minimize stress, right? Okay, so it can be fun, a hobby for many people. It's fun and a hobby. It can help with weight control, heart healthy, blood pressure. Use it or lose it, right? Okay, so we know all the good reasons, right? But yet, it's not really happening so much for many people, right? So what gets in the way? What are the obstacles to being more active?
Fear of being
more injured. Fear of injury, right?
And you feel like, oh, if I exercise, it can make
me feel worse. Fear of injury, either a current injury, a past injury, or future injury. Yep.
Just lazy.
Lazy, okay. You'd rather do something else. Rather do something else.
Not enough time.
Do you think that's like...
Not making enough time.
Okay, just say time, right? I'm going to do capital on that one, because that seems to be a really big one for many people. Anything else that comes... Don't know how to start, yeah? Question mark,
or
starting.
Don't know what type of exercise to do.
Start or what to do, yeah.
Also, money could be a factor. Maybe they think they can't afford to go to a gym.
Right, money.
Procrastination,
right? So some of these things tied in with what Kimberly was talking about in terms of reasons why we don't procrastination, why we're not eating certain ways too. Anything else come to mind? This is a shorter list than the one we did before of all the benefits, yes? Shorter list. So some people, it's not fun. They don't really enjoy it. I have a friend who makes herself go to exercise, but she's never really enjoyed it. She does it because she knows that it's good for her body, but doesn't ever enjoy it at all. Intimidated, kind of goes along with they don't know what to do, don't know where to start. Kind of goes along with that.
Sometimes they're embarrassed.
Giving some ideas of how to get beyond the obstacles. Okay, so in a perfect world, a lot of quotes around that, these guidelines are similar to what Kimberly presented. I'm going to say we want to do cardio, something that's our heart pumping, 2 to 3 times a week, maybe 30 to 60 minutes each. This is like a perfect ideal, maybe building up to that, right? Strength training, good for the bones, maybe 2 times a week, 15 to 30 minutes each. Something for the mind, so yoga, meditation, tai chi, you know, maybe 1 to 2 times a week. You can incorporate a little bit every day. So intensity of these things will vary over age, over as we age. So even if you've been very active your whole life, as you get older, you're going to want to do a little bit less intensity around that. And maybe over just certain times, you know, if we have some injury, we're going to want to slow it down for a while. But this is just a general guideline I'm saying in this perfect world, okay? Forget about it. Because we're not in a perfect world, right? Because remember this whole long list that kind of is like getting in our way, right? So I'm going to say, like, for now, don't worry about that. If you're not currently that active, it's going to be what Kimberly said about those micro goals, the little steps we want to take, okay? And it's much better to do something rather than nothing. So I've been doing yoga for like 20-something years, about 20 years, and I don't do it every day, and I never have done it every day, if you think about yoga as doing the movements that you do with yoga. My first time I ever tried a yoga class, when I was at work at Hewlett Packard, and they had somebody come in once a week, and so we learned some yoga with her, and people would ask, like, she was coming once a week, lunchtime, how often should I do this? And she said, oh, you should do it at least a couple times a week. At that time, I was working in Palo Alto, so with a commute, I had 2 little kids at home, and I've always exercised, and I said, I'm not going to do this more than this one class a week. Never mind, I'm not going to do yoga. Because she said, this teacher, to get the benefits, you've got to do two to three times a week. And me, even somebody who was into exercising my whole adult life, still said, I'm not going to do that. That's not going to happen. And so I didn't do it. I left the class because I just said, what's the point? And now, of course, I would never tell that to anybody that came to my classes, because whatever you do is better than nothing at all. Right? So here we go. may have seen this quote before. A year from now, you will wish you had started today, right? And that's very true for many things, not just exercising. And let me have the caveat. Before starting any new exercise program, make sure you have approval from your doctor, especially if you have any kind of health issues or injuries. So don't jump into something without that approval. Okay, now I'm going to start sharing some tips of things that have worked for me and other people that I know over the years in terms of getting started and being a little bit more active. If something resonates with you, jot it down. You have papers in front of you. At the end, if we'll have some time, you can share anything that may have worked for you or somebody that you know. There we go. Make it work for you. So know yourself. If you're a really competitive kind of person, you're going to want to train for some kind of race or set goals and compete against yourself or other people. If you're really intense, type A-ish, you may want to look for kind of a class that's boot camp and really, really intense. If you're into music, like we just did, it's really popular now, all kinds of dance things like Zumba and Bollywood and U-Jam and all kinds of, you can find classes like that all over town. If you like to be alone versus work with a group, you can find classes or not a class. If you like variety or you like to do the same thing over and over again because you got familiar with it, like just kind of start to think about how you operate in other parts of your life around things like that. Some people are really motivated to be like the slowest in the class and they get motivated by the other students, and others are totally intimidated and want to walk out of a class. So kind of think about that kind of stuff. Okay, so this picture is from our Keep It Moving class, one of them. And you can see how much fun everyone's having. Well, the small picture that I took, right? This is the thing we do where we pass balls around to the beat, like everyone's holding a ball in a circle, and that man in the middle was kind of gathering them up and not passing it on. So it became kind of fun, right? Okay. Find things that you like, and then you'll have fun. So we live in a wonderful community for being outside, places to take really nice walks. You don't have to go probably very far from your home at all. Even walking around the neighborhood is great. We have great trails and parks. Some people really like gyms, and there's a lot of them in the area, various different price ranges. And you can usually do a trial for a couple of days. You can try it and see what you like. If you are going to do something like that, make sure you go at a time of day that you would typically go. So then you'll see if it's too crowded, if there's classes there that you like. There's a lot of online classes out there. I haven't really used any of them, but these are two that I've heard about that are very good. One's called Booyah Fitness, and the other one is Yoga Glow, obviously more yoga-oriented. They all have a monthly membership fee, like $15 to $20, and they have very well-known instructors out there doing it. There's a lot of variety. The concern about doing online classes is if you don't know what you're doing, you're brand new, you don't have a teacher right there kind of looking at you and making sure you're doing it safely. But there's a lot of variety and it's convenient, obviously, right? You just do it in your home, whatever time works for you without having to go to a set class. So it's certainly something to look into if you think that's of interest to you. And then to sneak it into your day. That's probably a really good way to get started. Talk and walk. So depending what you do, if you're working, I have a good friend who works at home and she has a lot of conference calls and she'll just walk around her house while she's on the phone, right? If you are at an office working and that's possible for you to do, walk and talk, right? If you have to meet with somebody instead of just sitting at a desk, just walk around the building, take a walk outside. So incorporating the walks into your day. It's often said to add balance, right? So as you're brushing your teeth, you know, you can hold on to the counter. 1 minute, you know, I have the electric toothbrush, you know, with the timer, 30 seconds on one foot, 30 seconds on the, or yeah, 1 minute on one foot, 1 minute on the other foot, right? So adding in a little bit of balance. You don't have to hold on. You can if you need to. While you're cooking, if you're stirring, right? Balance a little bit. Just bring it into your day, okay? While you're doing laundry, add some little squats. Reach down, okay? When my daughter was a baby and colicky, right? I'd be holding her, you know? So find ways to sneak it in, and it's a good way to help build up strength in your legs if you're not used to doing that, maybe before you tackle something else. So adding it into your day. Park farther away. That's a really common one to hear, right? Park farther away. If you work at a desk, you know, the standing desks have gotten pretty common, really popular now, so you're not so sedentary. I've also seen a little pedal thing. It looks like a bicycle, just the pedals you put under your desk. I can't really demonstrate that, right? And it's like as you're sitting at your desk, you're just pedaling away, right? So there's a lot of new things out there that can help you sneak things into your day. My favorite one, make it a friend a date. This is me and my good friend, okay? We live in an area where we just walk really close to our neighbor on a trail. So double whammy, women, double whammy. There are studies that prove that women's overall health and well-being is improved when they get together with their friends. They say the study showed maximum of 4 friends, and you do something, okay? So you exercise with a friend, double whammy, okay? Double whammy. You're getting the benefits that study shows, plus the benefits of exercising, right? So less likely to skip, right? You have a date, somebody's pushing you to go out. You're more likely to push yourself a little bit, work a little bit harder with you with somebody. You may be willing to try something new, and you'll work out longer because blah, 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 you're gabbing with your friend and time will go by, okay? There's one friend in the picture and another good friend. We're neighbors and we try to go out a couple times a week. It started out, we'd always go at 8:30 at night. To your question about the evening, when my friend started doing it first, and I was like, no, then I won't sleep well. I don't want to walk at night. And then I eventually started joining them, and then I find I sleep better. Yeah. And part of it, I think, is mental, because we chat about our days, and I get everything out of my head, so I don't have to ruminate it when I'm laying in bed. So that may be a double thing. But it makes us very accountable. Like, we'll have this text group, I'm too tired to go tonight. Let's just go for 30 minutes, okay. And then what happens? 30 minutes turns into an hour. So it's a huge plus to find a workout buddy. Hold yourself accountable. Okay, if it works into your schedule and in your budget and all that, have a class that you take. Because you can't say, I'll go later or I'll take that walk later when you have a class at a certain date and a certain time. So I'm a big fan of doing a group class if it could work into your schedule and into your budget. There's a lot of ones, like we have the ones offered here, there's through the Fremont Rec Center, through the adult school, the senior center offers them. It's pretty easy to find classes offered that are not requiring a gym membership. And it's so much harder to say, I'll do it later when you've got to be somewhere Tuesday at 6 p.m. or whatever it may be. Put it on your calendar. If you're doing something by yourself without a commitment to a class, still put it on your calendar. Make it as important as your doctor's appointment or a meeting with your boss. Make it just as important as that. Some people want to commit to a charity event. There's a lot going on in the fall in this area. So these are 2 examples. Past weekend was a walk to end Alzheimer's. There's the Fremont Run for Education coming up. HERS Breast Cancer is a walk every year. There are 5Ks, 10Ks. You can walk, you can run. And so maybe there's a cause you care a lot about, and that's a few months out, and you want to get yourself ready for that. And so sometimes that's a good way to have a certain date in mind. And then another thing is tell someone your plan, your goals. Don't just keep it into yourself. Let somebody else hold you accountable. If you're working and you need to leave early or on time to get to have time to exercise, tell your best coworker friend. You know, I'm really wanting to leave every Tuesday. I want to be able to leave by 5:30 so that I can get home in time to take a walk or to go to a class, and let them help you reach that goal. If you have a family member that can help you with that, that's also true, whether you do it together or you do it separately, but you can help each other out, right? Hold yourself accountable for those goals. And then finally, set yourself up to succeed. I don't necessarily mean take starts this slow. So if you ever take a yoga class, this is the last thing you do in yoga. It's called a shavasana, a resting pose. So I didn't really mean that it starts slow, but I did mean it as it doesn't always have to be a super hard, powerful workout in order to have the benefit. Be realistic with your time and your abilities. If you're new to being active, if you're recovering from an injury or other health concerns, you don't start out running 5 miles, right? You're not gonna make it, you're gonna get hurt. Pace yourself, right? Very similar to what Kimberly was saying about changing the way that you eat. Set small goals, start out slowly, and before you know it, you'll be a lot more active than you are right now. It's better to do 5 minutes a day or once a week than to do nothing. If you haven't been exercising before, if you say, I'm going to do it every day, probably not, right? If you haven't been doing it yet, it's unlikely some magic thing just happened. So be realistic. Start slow. You've often heard the term weekend warrior. Those are people who do nothing all week, Monday through Friday, and then week on the weekend. They like overdo it, and then they're Monday sore and not able to get out of bed. So just find something that really will work for you and you think will be fun, and just ease yourself into it. And if you just want to lay down, at the end, that works too. I want to talk a little bit more about time. So working, kids, and commute, oh my, right? So if you are coming from work and that makes it hard for you to fit in exercising, I say don't go home first if you can work that out so that you don't have to go home right away. So once you get in the house, you're going to sit down, and then it's not going to happen, right? Mm-hmm. So try to maybe find a place to exercise closer to your work, whether it's after work or at lunchtime, or something on your way home, if you're able to swing that, depending on your home responsibilities. I used to say when my kids were younger and they were doing all kinds of activities, walk the field, right? So I'd be at a soccer practice. Instead of just sitting there, I'd walk around a game, right? So if that's something you have other family members you're helping to take care of, while they're in activities, you don't have to be sitting there watching. You can be being active during using those dime times. And get ideas from friends if you're really struggling with how to fit it into your day. You know, it's always easier to give advice to somebody else than to yourself, right? So find somebody that you think maybe could be helpful, or maybe you see somebody else, a friend or family member who's pretty active, and ask them how they get it to work, or just say, here's what I don't know, here's my schedule, oh, Dad, I'm so busy, and they'll probably help you figure it out, if you believe them, right? I find that helps in all kinds of problems. And maybe we'll get to a point that you want to find that exercise isn't getting in the way of your life, but it's it's adding to the quality of it and making it better. Okay? So before we close off, let's stay in our chair. Let me grab a chair so you can we're going to do in the chair. Oh. Okay, so move back a little bit from the table. I think there's enough space. Move back a little from the table. Okay, take the right foot forward and the heel is up. Have it on the floor. And then lean down to the legs. You should feel this in the back of the leg that's extended. Okay, in your hamstring, yeah. You may have the heel down to the floor. And if you pull the toe back again, you'll feel it in the calf. So leaning forward a little bit up the whole back of that leg. And then when you're stretching, it's good to make sure you're still breathing. Nice, slow breaths. And that's what yoga will teach you, to really connect with the breath. So the benefit of yoga, to give a little plug, is not only stretching and some strengthening and balance, but staying connected with the breath, and then that gets your mind and you get to calm down a lot. Okay, let's come back up. Let's go to the other side. So the toe is lifted, the heels to the floor, and then one hand to each leg as you lean forward. And come on back up. Okay, take the right ankle over the left ankle. And then let the knee open out to the side. Okay, you open that. So the ankle can stay low. Some of us may find that we can take that foot on top of the knee, of the other knee. Careful, you don't have to do that. You can keep it down over the ankle. You want to feel this in the outside of the right hip. Right, the knee, if the ankle's down low, you'll still open the knee out. Start to feel that. You may come it up halfway a little bit. Some people can take it up on top. So we sit a lot. So you can do this stretch if you're sitting at work or something, right? You can feel that on the outside of the top thigh, the hip there. If you want to get a little bit more, you can lean forward. So this is a great one to do in the course of a day. I don't recommend while you're driving, though. But if you're sitting at work or you're sitting at home at night watching TV, you can do this. And come on up and then take that leg and kind of shake it out a little bit. Okay, so the other side, left ankle over the right ankle, take the knee open out a bit. You may start to feel it right there. That's fine to stay there. Maybe you can take it up higher. Careful of the knee. Don't force it by any means. And then let's undo that leg. Okay, take the arms down and palms face forward, and then pull back, pull back. This is the one we need the most. So much of our day is spent in that hunched over position. So as much as you can do this throughout the day, anytime you have a second, a break, just stretch like this. That's good, right? I'll show you the version standing, right? You reach back and maybe your hands come together, right? If you want to get more, you can stand. And then if you have space, you can bend the knees and lean forward and take it up. All right, let's come back up. One more stretch. We're going to tilt the left ear down. And if you want, your hand can come and hold the head. Feel that right along the side here. And then take the other arm and reach it away. Another place we hold a lot of tension. And we have our tech neck, right? Head dropped down, looking at our phones, looking at our computers. So to counteract that, these two stretches are really important. And let's come back up. See a difference between your sides? Can you feel that? Tilt the other way. The hand can hold it if you want. And then stretch the arm away. And then take the hands back down. Okay, with breathing, lifting up. Stretch up, wriggle a little side to side. Okay, hold up, breathe in, lift up, and exhale, lower it down, and give yourself a hug. All right, we made it through.